Lao Fan's fourth lesson, the second lesson. Last time we talked about how Lao Fan changed his life, and now we're gonna talk about the second lesson. Exactly what do you do to change your life? There's actually ways to change your life for the better. So the second lesson is ways to reform. How do we reform? You want prosperity, happiness, a good thing to happen to you. You gotta have the cause to have the effect. So this tells us exactly what to do. First, you have to reform. That means change your faults and mistakes. First, we have to admit it. All the bad things that happened to us today is because of bad things that we did, either this life or prior lifetime or anything that we did before. That's why we are having this life we're experiencing right now. If we're poor, because we did not give in our prior lifetimes. If we don't have a good relationship, that is because we did something bad to people in the prior lifetime. So if we don't want the bad thing to continue, we gotta change our way to be virtuous. Fate and destiny is in your hands. You can do everything to change your life. There are four parts to today's reform. First is three ways of reform. And there are three methods of reforming. If your reform has been successful, there are signs you're doing right. And there are signs you're still having a lot of offenses and bad deeds. In order to change our life and change our mistakes, the first is feeling ashamed. Okay. Reflect on my fault. A lot of people don't even think doing anything wrong. At first you have to realize, oh, I'm kind of lazy, you know, that's why I'm not doing well. Or, I want to lose weight, but I didn't eat a lot of chocolate. You don't know what you're doing wrong. You have to reflect. How come Buddha can be a Buddha? He started like a normal person, just like us, with many faults. But he changed his way. How come he's able to do that? And we're still a mundane person. First, feel shameful. When you feel shameful, you can change. I don't know if you guys heard of this guy. His name is Nick. He was born with no arms and no legs. But he can do everything that we're doing. And he even can swim, he can do all the sports. And now he's 30, 40, and he's making speeches everywhere, giving motivational speeches to all the young people, telling them how to live a good life and never give up. He said, I have no arms and no legs and no worries. We should be shameful, you know, he can be happy, how come we can't? We're still having so much trouble and so much difficulty in our life. So we should first feel ashamed of ourselves. Second, we want to feel fear. What do we mean by fear? Fear means feeling respect. When you're by yourself or you think nobody knows, or the Buddha and all the spirits are watching us. Don't think of evil thoughts or pick your nose or, you know, do all the thing that you will not do in front of people because the gods are watching us. So everything that you're doing is recorded. And all the good things will have good fortune. All the bad things will have bad results. So don't think nobody knows. Live every day as if all the gods are watching you all the time. So be good all the time. So there's a story. Two people, they think they're talking by themselves, nobody knows. And first they were talking about all the good things. They're talking about Dharma. So all the heavenly beings, they came by and watching them, you know, talking about all the good things. And after a while, because of their bad habits, they start gossiping. And all the heavenly beings left. After a while, they start saying even worse things. All the evil gods, they come by and they actually spit on them. All the gods and all the deity and all the spirits, they know exactly what we're doing. So be good all the time, even when you're alone. That is a way to cultivate and become good. So that's the second way of reform. The third way is determination. You want to be successful, you have to be determined. I want to change my way from today on. How come we want to go on a diet, quit smoking, not be angry, and we can't do it? What's the reason? Because we're always giving ourselves a lot of excuses. I'll do this later. Because of this and that, because of other people. We have a lot of excuses. That's why we can't reform. So you gotta do it right away. I hear about this book today, from today on, I'm gonna reform, I'm gonna change my ways. There is a man, he was only 20, he learned how to be virtuous. He said, oh, I gotta change my way. He tried really hard every day to change his way, but he still felt like he's not doing enough. He kept changing, till he was 50. And he still thinks he's not doing enough. He still has a lot of faults and mistakes, you know, offenses. And so he keeps changing, keep changing. All the saints and all the sages said this is a great man who knows how to change himself because he's constantly aware of his thoughts and changing. So we gotta be determined for you to really have any kind of reform in your life. Okay, so that's the third way to reform. There are three methods of reform. First is changing through behavior. If I don't wanna smoke, then I just cut down how many cigarettes every day. You know, I cut it down. So I change by the actual behavior. I force myself. I can't smoke every day. You know, I cut it down. So I change by the actual behavior. I force myself. I can't smoke. I can't smoke. I force myself no more chocolate, or no more cake, no more sweet. I force myself. I don't get angry. I won't be mad at anyone. I force myself. But that is only temporary. So the second way is changing through reasoning. If you know the reason, then you will be able to change. Okay, for example, smoking is really bad for your health. Or getting angry is not necessary because when someone is slandering about you, if he's right, I should change my ways. If he's wrong, why should I be angry? I shouldn't even listen, right? If you know the reasoning, there's no point being upset. And there's no point smoking, you know, no point eating a lot of junk food, right? So if you know the logic behind it, then you're likely to reform forever. The third is the ultimate way, is changing from the heart. We have numerous mistakes, right? If you change one at a time, it takes a long time. But if you just change from the heart, because everything stems from your heart. If you just change your heart to be pure and virtuous, you will have no more offenses. You have no more mistakes. You have no more faults because your heart is constantly still and peaceful and you're not having a lot of thoughts. Okay, so this is like meditation. Your heart is very calm and your mind is clear. You're not likely to do a lot of bad deeds or have faults. So that's changing from the heart. If you really want to reform, you need to do all these three. Combine them, then you can change yourself for the better. There are signs of you actually were successful. You will feel these things. This thing will happen to you. First, you will naturally feel light and generous. You have a good mood. Nothing's happening, but you feel very joyful. You're in good mood all the time. Okay? And the second one is because of all the good things and virtues, you become wise all of a sudden. You kind of know everything. You kind of know what I should do with everything and without any confusion. And the third is relax in turmoil. When a lot of bad things happening, it's very hectic. You're still very relaxed, calm. Even when there's a lot of trouble around you, okay, you still feel peaceful and you're not moved. The fourth is you're happy seeing an enemy. Usually we see an enemy, we are very angry or we try to hide or we pretend we're nice but we're not. But when you really reform, even when seeing someone you don't like, you are genuinely sincere and happy and treat him like a loved one. That means you have really changed yourself to be able to see an enemy and be happy. The fifth is dream of spitting black things. Okay, a lot of these are dreams. You will notice in your dreams, you spit out black things. Black things means offenses, bad deeds. In your dream, you're actually spitting out black stuff. That means all your bad deeds are gone. You're starting anew. Okay? So seeing yourself spitting out bad things, that's good. The sixth is dream of past sages. Sometimes in your dreams, you might see Jesus, or you can see Buddha, or you can see someone very virtuous and encourage you. That is a very good sign. That means you have become a virtuous person. Okay, so that's the sixth one. The seventh one is when you dream of flying. Okay, flying is good. That means you're free of offenses and evil darkness. And the eighth is dream of panades and canopies. All the decorated, pretty stuff like we have here, that means you are having an auspicious life. That's good signs. All the pretty and beautiful things that's decorative in your life that you dream of them. Okay, so these are the good signs of that you have reformed. But there are also bad signs. Pretty much they're the opposite. When you're not doing well or you're actually not really reforming and you're still going on with your old ways, this is what will happen to you. First, feeling confused and oppressed. You have no energy. You feel like, oh, every day I'm sluggish and I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, that means you have a lot of offenses. Secondly, you can be very forgetful. You forget your keys, you forget all your work, you don't know where you left it because you're very confused. The third is worrying about nothing. Nothing is going on. You're just sitting at home, but you're very worried about everything. Nothing is happening, but you're worried. That is also a sign of offense. The fourth is embarrassing virtuous people. When someone is virtuous, you don't want to see the person because you know you feel shameful. You don't want the other person to see you. And the fifth is displeased with proper teaching. When you hear good teaching, you're not interested. You don't want to listen because you don't want to reform. And the sixth, when kind receive hostility. Okay? When you have a lot of offenses, you're kind to others, other people treat you badly. Okay? Even if you give people presents, they mad at you. That means something you're not doing too well nowadays, okay? Because people naturally don't like you. Okay. And then seven, you have a lot of nightmares. You're having a lot of nightmares upside down and all kind of dark stuff, or you're not flying, you're falling. You know? That means you're doing a lot of bad things. And the last one, talk incoherently. You don't know what you're saying. You're saying like random things. Your speech and your behavior is not normal. A lot of this interesting signs that you can tell if you're doing good or you're doing bad. From now on, after you hear of this Lao Fan's Four Lesson, what we do is we are positive and we are very active in changing our life for the better. Okay? Do all that is good and get rid of all our bad habits and all our mistakes and our offenses. So the next class, we're gonna talk about how to cultivate good deeds. Okay, so this is to reform, and the next chapter, we're gonna really do all the good deeds. Okay, so that's the class for today. Thank you for listening. 阿弥陀佛。
阿弥陀佛。